You want to know the best and the quickest way you can get websites up and running for you and for your clients using HighLevel, then this video is for you. What is up, guys? Thank you so much for tuning into today's video. My name is Jason McElchar. I run a software company called GrowthRate. We work with local businesses to help them set up a ton of different things like websites, reputation management, and a ton more. In today's video, I'm going to be going over the easiest and the quickest and the fastest way that you can get a website up and running for your clients using HighLevel. This process does not take long at all. I'm going to go over how to actually pick your website template, how to change things on that website, and also how to connect up the domain to that website so you can get that website live on the internet for people to actually go ahead and search for. Before we get into it, if you are currently not already using HighLevel, there's an extended 30-day free trial, completely free, down below in the description. It's the first link down there. Myself and HighLevel recently partnered up to offer that exclusive extended 30-day free trial. They do not come around very often. So if you do want to start a software business or even a website development agency like how I'm going to show you on here, then HighLevel is the go-to platform to use to get this up and running. Once you get signed up, you get access to a ton of different benefits and resources like the Start Your SaaS course. We do weekly coaching calls. You get one-to-one mentorship and a ton more, but I'll touch on that a bit more at the end of today's video. So we're gonna head straight over to the computer, and as you can see, I am in my HighLevel. It's not called HighLevel, obviously. If you know a bit about HighLevel, you're able to white label it. It's called GrowthRate. That's my software right there, so my clients don't see anything to do with HighLevel on here. They only see GrowthRate. All we gotta do is, actually the first thing we'll do is connect up the domain, because I know that is the part that a lot of people get stuck on. So you want to head over to one of your sub accounts. So this is either going to be your sub account where you're going to get your website up and running on, or it's going to be a client sub account where you're going to be connecting up a website for one of your clients. If you're unsure of what a sub account is, I have a ton of different videos on this, a ton of different resources over on my channel, but pretty much every time you sign a client, they get access to their own sub account within HighLevel. This allows you to sort of keep everything separate for your clients, so none of your clients see each other's stuff. It's all completely separate. They only see the stuff that they have access to in their sub account. So first thing you want to do is head over to a sub account and head over to settings. Then over on the left, we want to scroll down to domains over here on the left, this navigation over here on the left. Once we then click on domains over on the left, we want to click on add a domain. And if you're unsure of what a domain is, then an example of a domain is something like tesla.com or google.com, or like my domain for my business is GrowthRate. You want to set this up so whenever someone searches for your domain, then that domain will actually redirect to the website, so it shows the website on there. Exactly the same if you go to something like apple.com or again tesla.com. If you go to Google and you search tesla.com, it'll take you to the Tesla website. Same with Apple, same with growthrate.info. What you want to do here in connect your domain slash subdomain is you want to type the domain URL, and for here you just want to type the domain. So to purchase a domain, I highly recommend use something like GoDaddy, because GoDaddy is the easiest one that you can use. Get set up for your client. There's a ton of different options out there, like you got Namecheap, you got Google Domains, but the thing is Google Domains recently got bought out, so you can't actually use Google Domains anymore. So I just recommend using GoDaddy. It's the most simple in terms of actually getting DNS records added in here, connecting up different things, so you can get this up and running in as quick as time possible. So pretty much you just want to head over to GoDaddy, and if you haven't already bought a domain for yourself, you want to search for it in here. So let's just type out, so let's just say your business was called Irish Marketing Agency, which don't call your business that. This is just an example on here. So all we want to do is type Irish Marketing Agency. And as you can see, we get a few different options right here. IrishMarketingAgency.com, IrishMarketingAgency.eu. Then you scroll down, there's a few other things like IrishMarketingAgency.beer. I can see why they got that one right there. You want to choose the most simple one that you'll remember, and it's also the most easiest domain for your clients to remember. So I always recommend if the .com domain is available, then choose .com. Maybe even something like .co, but I would never choose any of these like .design, .beer, .luxury, .blog, .xyz, maybe .net, not .org, sometimes .info like growthrate.info, not .online, .biz, .club. You want to try and choose something like .com because it's the most simple to remember. It's the most widely known. Whenever you are setting things up, they're going to go publicly online, no matter if it's to do with content, a domain, a website. You got to remember that, yeah, you know something that you're setting up isn't like a scam and it's legit and everything, but the people on the other side, they don't know anything at all about you the first time they go on the website or they see the domains. So you want to have it looking as legit as possible, and that's just why I always recommend .com. Or even if you're an Irish business, maybe get .ie. I know you cannot get .ie domains on GoDaddy. You'll need to use something like Hosted in Ireland. Or if you're in the UK, you can get .co.uk. Doesn't matter, you wanna get something simple. I already have a domain. I'm just gonna use the jasonmcelchar.com domain. I'll head over there right now. So here's a few of the domains I currently have. If we go to jasonmcelchar.com, then you want to click on domain over on the left and then manage DNS. So we want to add a brand new record, and we also need to make sure if there's any other A records at the top. So if the types, you see the way we have NS, CNAME, TXT, the A records usually are at the top. If you have any other A records that in the name they have the at symbol, you want to be able to delete those. You want to delete those, I'll show you in just a second. But we want to add new record, and the type in here is going to be A, and I'll actually show you over in HighLevel. So if we go domain, type jasonmcelchar.com, and then yes, I also want to add www.jasonmcelchar.com, add record manually. So it gives us two records in here. The first one is an A record and the host is this at symbol. So we're gonna click on this, we're gonna copy that. So type is A and the name we're going to paste. Then over in value, it gave us this value 34.68.234.4. We're gonna click on this to copy it. Then wanna head over to value and paste this. And instead of hitting save, we're just gonna click on add more records because we got two records to add in here. As you can see, the next type is a CNAME record. The name is then www. We wanna copy this, paste it in here, and then the record value, we'll just copy this because it doesn't show the full things. It is flash.funnels.msgsndr.com. These are the only two records that you need to add in to get this website live and up and running. A lot of people overcomplicate this process. It's not difficult. As you can see, I just did that in like 30 seconds. It's extremely simple to do. Don't let this hold you back if you're trying to set up websites for your clients or for yourself. So you wanna click on save all records. Now, as you can see, record name www conflicts with another record. So if we scroll down, as you can see, I already have a record with www as a CNAME. We wanna delete this one. Sometimes GoDaddy can automatically add in records that it might think you're gonna use. So you can usually delete them. If it's a brand new domain, you haven't used anything, then you can delete records. But if your domain already has other things up and running, like a Google workspace, so an email on there, so you know, like jason@jasonmcelchar.com or just some sort of inbox, then you want to be careful with the different records that you're actually deleting. So we're going to click on save all records here again. And as you can see, success, it says right here, it can take up to 48 hours. Usually these only take like 30 seconds to a minute to add in. So we're just gonna click on verify records. Again, like I said, this should not take very long at all. And then it says domain added successfully, link domain with funnel. I don't already have a website in here, but I already do have a template for some teeth whitening set. Whenever your website is actually added in here, which we're gonna do in the next step, all you gotta do is click on the website. So for example, we're just gonna choose on the teeth whitening. Select the default funnel step. That's gonna be the claim page. Usually this is like the home page. It's usually the very first step on there. So whenever someone goes for jasonmcelchar.com, it's gonna take them to the home page. And then obviously you got other pages, like you got pricing and you got about and contact us and everything. Additional options, the 404 page, you're just gonna click on the claim page again, which would be the home page. You can set up a 404 page for if, you know, redirecting to from a page that doesn't actually exist. We're gonna click on link domain. Now to actually create the website, we're gonna click on go back, and then we're gonna navigate over to site. Then up the top, we wanna click on website, new website. And if you want to start a website from scratch, from blank, you can just type out a name here, but we're actually gonna choose a website template in here because the whole purpose of this is to get a website up and running in as quick as time for your clients. So we're gonna click on continue. And as you can see, HighLevel has literally thousands and thousands and thousands of website templates in here for a ton of different industries. If we scroll up here on the left, as you can see, this is all the industries right here. So we've got automotive, beauty and fashion, holidays, insurance, legal, marketing agency, real estate, bar, restaurant. I'm gonna click on bar and restaurant. And again, you can choose any of these templates whatsoever. And I kind of like the look of the brew pub one. So we click into this, we can full screen it just to sort of take a look at what it looks like before we do end up going with this. And yeah, that does look good. So we're gonna click on continue. Currently it is adding the template, it's adding in all the pages. And as you can see, it is now in here. It usually just gives us around 30 seconds or so to load in. Gonna go back a step and go back into Brewpub, and now, yeah, it has loaded up. So to get this up and running in as quick as time possible, and let's just say it's just some sort of business that wants to get a quick website up and running, all you gotta do is edit each page. So we're gonna click on the arrow, edit in a new tab, so it opens in a brand new tab for us to edit. And as you can see, we have the template in here. It says logo, it has the images. So we can change any of the text on here. So we can go nice beer, for example. We can change everything here. And let's just say this image right here, let's just say we wanted to take it in on the right slightly. We can click it, go margin, and we can drag this up. And it is now pushed that over in to the left from the right a bit. Then we can scroll down, say if we wanted to make this section bigger right here, we can click on this, the margin at the top, let's just make that bigger. Obviously you would need to, you know, fix the background in here, change the actual background color. So click on background, background color, we'll go red, for example, even though that is not the right color. Just shows you how to sort of mess around with all this stuff. You can click on any image here, so let's just actually take the logo here one. So let's upload our logo or our client's logo. So I'm gonna click on logo here, then over on the right, we're going to scroll down and it says brand logo, and it has this URL in here. This is the URL for the logo here. This is just a placeholder logo that HighLevel put in there. We're just gonna click on the image logo and it says relocated item. And what we're actually going to do, instead of going into that folder, we're gonna upload a brand new file and we're going to find the logo. I'm just gonna upload the growth rate logo, which is the logo for my own business right there. We're gonna double click this and it is uploading. And we literally just double click that. And as you can see, growth rate is now a craft beer company. We can make this smaller if we just click on this. We can go scroll down and what we can actually go for is the width. So as you can see, the width is currently 180. We can change this to 120. As you can see, it's smaller, so it just sort of blends in a bit more with all of the other navigation stuff in here. That's pretty much everything when it comes to like the quickest and the most simple way to get websites up and running for clients. There's a few other things in here that you can do. Like, let's just say we will add a new column in here. We'll add one column. We'll add an element. And we can add different things like calendar, for example. This dentist offer calendar. That's the calendar that's actually already in the sub account right here. It loads in the calendar. Obviously in the back end, you want to configure the calendar so it's the right times and everything on there. There's so many other things that you can add, like let's add another element and we'll scroll down. We got buttons, we got image sliders, FAQs, we can add in custom code, reviews, countdown. For this, we'll just add in a simple button, click the sign up, and we will go for, change the theme to this blue one right here. In general, we'll scroll down, we'll change it from click the sign up to click to get beer. And then the link to, we are going to go website URL and in the website right here. And for button actions, we'll go link to website URL. And in website right here, we can choose whatever URL we want to do in here. So I'm actually gonna take this to my free course offer, startyoursaas.growthrate.info/. So then if we go save, and we'll actually preview this instead. So if you preview it, it'll automatically save everything. Click on preview again and it should preview the website on here with everything uploaded, nice beer logo. If you scroll down, click to get beer. We can actually click on this button right here and it takes you to my free course on here. So yeah, that's pretty much the easiest way to just add in buttons, get it all up and running and everything. And if you are interested in that free course, the link for that will be down in the description. So yeah, that's pretty much everything. That's the quickest way to get a website up and running for your client. So now actually, just before we finish up, we'll click on go back over here on the left and say now we want to change this from that teeth whitening website to the brand new craft beer website. All we got to do is go back to settings, back down to domains. And what we can actually do is see the three dots right here. We'll click on edit for both of these and the default page is going to be Brewpub Home, and we'll save this. This is for the www.1. Now we also got to do this for the root domain, the main domain, the jasonmcelchar.com one. And that's updated. We'll do the three dots again, edit, teeth whitening to Brewpub Home, and save. So now, whenever someone goes to jasonmcelchar.com, it will take you to the Brewpub Home. Probably going to be down by the time you see this. If you do want to search for jasonmcelchar.com, go for it. That website might still be there. It might be updated. I don't know. We'll see by the time you're actually watching this. So yeah, that's pretty much everything when it comes to getting a website up and running for a client in its quickest time possible. It's over how to actually find a template, how to change image on there, how to add a calendar, how to add a button, and how to connect the domain to the website. If you do have any questions whatsoever, you can either drop them down below or reach out to me over on Instagram. I'll leave the link for that down below again. Like I mentioned at the start of this video, if you're currently not already using HighLevel, then there is an exclusive extended 30-day free trial link down below. Once you get signed up, you'll get access to everything, like I mentioned, from the Start Your SaaS course, weekly calls, one-to-one mentorship, pretty much everything that you need to start this business, get it up and running, and also get your first 5 to 10 clients. We'll work one-on-one. Will help you get those clients on board in as quick as time possible so you can start generating revenue in as quick as time possible. And if you're already an existing user of HighLevel, I will leave another link down below. You can go through that link, you can upgrade. And if you do upgrade using my link down below, it'll be another link. It'll probably be the second one. Just click on it, you'll see it down there. Just send me over a DM over on Instagram. Just let me know that you've upgraded and I will give you access to everything there is to get access to. Thank you so much for tuning into today's video and I'll see you in the next one.